My name's Kevin Turvey, and I'm an investigative reporter, which means I investigate things and then report on them. Most of my work's based in Redditch, sometimes the library, sometimes, you know, somewhere else, because that's where I live, you see. I'm not employed by anybody to do it. I just employ myself whenever I want. It's better that way, because if you was employed by a big organisation, you wouldn't have the freedom to investigate at will, as it were. Like most people, my week begins at 9 o'clock on Monday morning. Right, Mick?
Is that you, Kevin?
And did you think it was the day of clock five?
No.
Well, then. What's this?
What's what?
What is this brown stuff in the vase?
That's your sherry, Kevin.
Sherry? What's this D-Day?
Kevin, Orson Welles drinks it.
Yeah?
I'm hungry.
Come on, Mum, we're hungry.
Kevin, could you come in here a moment?
Just been checking for you in the kitchen, Mick. It's nearly ready now.
Oh, gentlemen. Have you been spending a pleasant day?
Not really, I've only just got up.
No, you haven't. If you'd only just got up, Raj, you'd still be in your pyjamas.
I never wears pyjamas.
How do you know?
I do the washing, don't I?
Yeah, but what if he never puts his pyjamas in to be washed?
Are you calling me the sort of person who doesn't wear pyjamas and wouldn't wash them even if he did wear them? Or a liar?
I think I've made myself quite clear on that point, if you don't mind, Mick. I think we're all a little bit more interested in our dinner at the moment, actually.
Right, Michael. I think we're ready.
My mum's an executive receptionist at a hairdresser's in town. And Mick, that's the lodger, he's currently in between jobs. He left the army very recently, actually. Under, well, secret circumstances. He's not really allowed to talk about it. But we do know it was very sudden. It's such a big secret, actually, that even when the bloke from the army comes round asking where he is, we have to say that we've never heard of him. It's only a small family, but, well, I mean, what am I supposed to do about it? I'm not God, am I? Watch till then.
He's always been, how shall I say, a bit of a loner. Bit of a Clint Eastwood figure. No, people don't like him very much. Well, he doesn't look much like Clint Eastwood, I know. Although, he did once have a hat.
Monday, May the 17th, 8:48 a.m. Great, bang on time as usual.
Ah!
What a beautiful day. It's so great to be alive today because it's the early bird that gets worms. And I wonder what's in the stores for me this week. Another busy week's investigations, I expect. Come in, whoever you are, Mother.
Good morning, Kelly.
Good morning, Mother.
How are you this afternoon?
I'm very well, thank you. And what is it that you've got there?
Well, this morning I brought a cup of tea and your mail.
Thank you very much. Dear Mr. Turdy, you have been selected from literally millions of householders without double glazing to take part in this fabulous opportunity of a lifetime. You would have to be a brain-damaged moron or the victim of a cruel medical experiment if you did not tick the box marked yes. I reckon that's from them double glazing people. This tea's cold.
Of course it is. I've been waiting outside the door for half an hour for you to start talking.
Well, it's horrible. It's like drinking. You're sick. Come and wait a bit later in the future. Was there anything else?
Yes.
Good. Well, then that will be all, Mother. Thank you. So, another interesting week begins to happen. Most of my weeks tend to start on a Monday, here in my bedroom. This is all my bedroom, everything you can see. As you can see, I've got a bed in it, right? I keep it over here by the window, because that's exactly the same place that I go to sleep, right? Wouldn't be any good to me if I kept it over the other side of the room, because I'd just crack my head open every time I wanted to have a bit of a kip. Besides which, I'd never get it on top of the wardrobe, you see. I suppose I could put it inside the wardrobe, you know, but then where would I put my clothes?
Kevin, you finished in the bathroom.
What does it look like?
It's sort of pink with a bath in it.
No, I mean, does it look as if I'm in the bathroom or not? Anyway, as I was saying, mate...
No, it doesn't.
What are you doing dressed up as my mother?
Well, I told you. I don't wear pyjamas.
All right, mate. Anyway, as I was saying again, mate, shall we have a look in my diary to see what I've decided to investigate today? Now, normally, I'd keep my diary in my desk over there, right? But as I knew you was coming, I've laid it out on the table down in the kitchen. So shall we go and see if we can find it? But I put it on the table last night.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Well, where is it then? Who's stolen it?
Somebody's stolen it.
Well, somebody has. It's not there.
I put it on the sideboard.
Well, you might have told me.
I didn't tell you.
No, you didn't. That's a load of f***ing lies. There it is. I've got it. Shall we have a little look? Monday. Crikey, there's millions of Mondays in here. Just a bit of a joke. Ain't that stupid? I beg your pardon? All right, mate. Oh, yeah. In this town, right, the park is completely corrupt. The swing has never been cleaned, and it's regularly used by people over 14. I've never once seen a band in the so-called self-styled bandstand, in inverted commas. And to top it all, right, we're supposed to live in a democracy, right? And every evening when the sun goes down, they slam the gates shut on the people. And, you know, on each other, like. What's going on? Who is responsible? Name the guilty men. Unless they're, you know, guilty women. In which case, name the guilty women and leave the guilty men out of it. And why? This is Kevin Turvey in the park. I've only been here 3 minutes, and already I've noticed this. Keep off the grass, my foot. Who put it there? And how? The sign, I mean, not my foot. The park keeper put it there, that's who. And how did you get it there, Mr. Park Keeper? Did you fly? Have you got wings? Or did you throw it there, you know, with a little bit of string tied onto it? So as if it didn't stick in first time, you could tug it and get it back. And maybe with a special little knot on it, so that if it did stick in the first time, you could give it a special pull on the string so as the knot would come undone and you could get the string back. Eh? I think not. I'll tell you how you did it. You kept on the grass. So, it appears that the very man who's telling us to keep off the grass is keeping on it himself.
Right, now, at this very moment, right, it's 3:32:53. Well, look, call it 3:33. There's nobody looking. At this very moment, right, the park keeper's probably having his afternoon tea in his little house over there. Let's see if he's game for a laugh. I doubt it very much, mate.
Sorry, planning his excuse.
Yes?
My name's Kevin Turvey.
Yes?
Not you again.
Surprise, surprise. Are you or are you not the park keeper?
No comment, you ugly bastard.
Well, my name's Kevin Turvey and I accuse you of walking about on the grass.
What did you call me?
I didn't call you anything.
Yeah, tell that to your Spanish boyfriend. Take it round to the cleaners, you vermin, and stick it where it hurts.
Listen, mate, don't get evasive. We've got concrete evidence.
Oh, yeah, and my mother's got rabies.
Listen, I'm not interested in your mother.
You leave my mother out of this, you disgusting lump of stinking fungus. You slutted, you gentleman's lavatory. Why don't you crawl back to the Mediterranean with all your Korean sugar daddy pimp friends and hang around the harbour looking for dead fish? That's what your kind likes to do, isn't it, Mr. President, sir? God, excuse me while I'm crucified upside down. Oh, right. Never mind the Mexicans. They'll look after themselves, won't they, General de Gaulle? I've blown your nose recently. Pardon me, boy. Is that the Chattanooga choo-choo?
Never said anything about his mother. And if I did, it was an accident. Anyway, how am I supposed to know he's got a mother? What am I supposed to do? Guess. Go up to him and say, oh, excuse me, Mr. Parkkeeper, my name's Kevin Turvey. By the way, I accuse you of walking about on the grass. But mainly, I think your mum's great. I'm not going to say that, am I? I'm not an idiot. Anyway, listen. One thing's for sure, right? Well, two things is for sure, right? Come to think of it, there's millions of things that's for sure, right? But the important thing that's for sure, one of the important things, right, that's for sure, is that that man is going to think twice before he starts walking about on the grass again. If he can.
I've got four pairs of shoes, right? Now, one of them's brown and the rest are black. Now, I'll let in the brown ones. In fact, I have done on a couple of occasions, but not the black ones. I know it sounds odd, but it's just the way I like to live my life.
That I like. Piranha, cod, whales. That's the fish, right? Not the place. I mean, the area. Not the place, it's the fish. I'll put myself up now. And mackerels. And fish that I don't like. Chub, bass, any green fish, like green bottles, octopus, and squid. And the reasons I like these ones are cod is great to eat. You can have it with chips if you want, or you can have it with peas. You can even have it on its own. And it's quite cheap, considering that it's dead, right? And whales are very big. It's about it for whales, really. Oh, and they've got a great hole in the top of their head that they can spray water with. And mackerels are great swimmers. Well, all fish have to be, really. Otherwise, they just go and drown, right? But mackerels are especially great. Otherwise, how come they ain't extinct? And if you notice the ones that I don't like, right, they've all got one thing in common, haven't they? Can you spot it? That's right, they're all crap. But, you see, good fish or bad fish, they're all fish, ain't they? And that's it, man. Aha! I can see that you're fishing. Aha, I can see that you're fishing. Aha!
Ow!
I can see that you're...
You just kicked me!
No, I didn't. Aha!
Yes, you did. You just kicked me.
No, I didn't. Aha, I can see that you're fishing.
Tommy, is that your rod, mate?
Who did kick me then?
Is that your rod there?
Going on about?
Look, I just want to know if that's your rod or not.
Cause it's my bloody rod. Do you think I'll nick teeth?
Look, I'm just asking you a question. Now, look, isn't it a nice day, mate?
No.
Well, then, do you think that football is better than fishing or not?
Yeah.
Aha, in that case, why are you fishing, mate?
Because I want to catch some fish!
Look, I know... Listen, Mick, how many fish do you think there is in this lake?
I should say about 7...
So, there you have it. Whether you're playing football or fishing, there's more fish in there than 6.
Or maybe 8.
I forget it. It's just a complete waste of time. It's a goal. And now let's have a bit of a song from a great mate of mine, Keith Marshall.
Wake up, England. Brack, brack, brack. Brack, brack, brack. Brack, brack, brack. Tish. You don't know what to think. The washing up is in the sink. It's a drag. A real drag. There's nothing much to do. If you haven't got a zoo, have a fag. A real fag. Why don't you listen to me? Keith Marshall and his musical anarchy. Keith Marshall and his musical anarchy. Radio's a waste of time. Television doesn't rhyme with anarchy. Not really. Football is a game. French Wolf is a stupid name. Can't you see? They've all gone crazy. Why don't you listen to me? Keith Marshall and his musical anarchy. Keith Marshall and his musical anarchy, yeah. Saxophone break. Ba 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 ba. Not a saxophone. Ba 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 ba. Why don't you listen to me? Why don't you listen to me? Don't you listen to me, Keith Marshall and his musical anarchy, Keith Marshall and his musical anarchy, Keith Marshall and his musical anarchy, yeah. Look out, there's a spaceman in the sky.
Items of interest, 49. You know when you spread butter onto cream crackers, they all crack and fall apart and everything? Well, if you dip them in water first, right, and then spread the butter on really carefully, like with a hairbrush, and leave them somewhere warm to dry for about 8 hours and 10 minutes, well, then you've got great cream crackers ready spread.
A bit late, weren't you, Kevin?
Yeah. This amazing thing happened to me.
Yeah?
Yeah. Hands up, who likes Yugoslavia? Aha! I thought so. Then what have you got against the Yugoslavians?
They eat frogs.
No, that's the French.
What? They eat the French?
No, no, it's the French that eat the frogs. Well, you know, they eat their legs.
What about the rest of them?
Well, I don't know. They probably keep them in little homes.
What?
They probably like keep the frogs in little homes and teach them to walk about on their hands.
What for?
Because they can't make wheelchairs that small.
I bet the Japanese could.
Yeah, but the Japanese don't eat frogs, do they? Now, I'll tell you what they do. They probably make the frogs little tin legs, right, with springs inside them, so as they can bounce about the place and never ever notice that half of them's been eaten.
What a load of bollocks. They'd notice at bedtime, wouldn't they?
No. Not if they was on Valium, no.
No, it wouldn't work. No, what they do is they give all the attendants little catapults, and they could flick the frogs about everywhere, you know, ponds and trees and things, without them having to make any effort, right? So, if one of the frogs should realise he hasn't got any legs, they could just flick it over a wall or something before he let the others know. Listen, lad, you should do what you want to do.
Yeah, but I do.
Listen, if you're under the thumb, it's the worst thing.
But I ain't under the thumb.
Look, say you're here, right? Right?
Yeah.
And say that's a thumb, right? And you're here. It's the worst thing.
But what if I'm not there? What if I'm here? Ah, you didn't think about that, did you?
Makes no difference.
Yeah, but I'm not going to be there if there's a thumb there, am I?
It doesn't matter.
Because I'm not stupid, you know. If I can see, like, a thumb, I'm not going to walk under it, am I? And you know why? Because...
And anyway, he's not married.
Oh, no, so what?
Well, you know, if he ain't married, Nick.
Yeah, all right. Well, if I'm under the thumb, how come I was in the pub?
Listen, mate. You are under the thumb.
Simple, just ask the fridge. Ask the fridge what he's doing. All right, well, we'll just have to eat the boat. Yeah, well, I don't like the taste of salt water either, mate, so listen, don't start getting clever about everything or I'll just drop you out the aeroplane. Yeah, make a nice mess from 40,000 feet, that will, yeah. Ah, this must be his office in here. Good morning, God. Good morning, Barbie Jesus. I'm sorry I'm a little bit late. I had to go to Parliament. See? But it's about all these Japanese action men that came out of the TV. See? Dave the Elephant, he sat on them. Yeah. God, do you mind if I turn the lights down a bit? Don't bother yourself, I'll do. I've got to turn the lights on. Excuse me. What's my bed doing in here? Someone's dribbled in my mouth. What are we doing in my bedroom? Okay, look, we're doing in the morning. No, forget it. I'll just... there you are, Godzilla. Did you bring the car with you?
Downtown. Everything's great when you're downtown. Don't wait a minute for downtown. Everything's waiting for you. Downtown. 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 So go the great words to one of Petulia Clark's great songs that I know called Downtown. And do you know, although she never said what town it was, the song seems almost relevant, even today. Because, you see, no matter who you are, right, even if you're the Prime Minister or someone like that, right, you've got to go downtown. Unless you're there already, you know, unless you live downtown or something like that. But even then, right, you've got to go downtown to go to your house, haven't you? And how do you get downtown? On the bus. Right, I've been waiting at this bus stop for 20 minutes, right? And I don't think it's working properly. Because only one bus has come along. And I didn't get on that one, right, because... it was full up, actually, which is quite interesting. But what I'll do is, when another bus comes along, I'll get on that one, you know, once it's stopped. I won't bother actually getting on it while it's still going along, because they keep the doors closed, you see, and you tend to sort of bounce off and get headaches. But anyway, the thing is, the situation's getting a bit more serious, right? Because some of the shops that I want to go to close at lunchtime. So if I'm not downtown in the next 17 minutes, right, then I'm going to have an extra 8 pence to pay on this library book, if my watch is working properly, which I don't know. So the situation's getting a bit hairy. Wait a minute, we're in luck, there's a taxi. All right, mate. Have you got the time, please?
Yeah, 12:34. Where do you want to go?
I know, it's all right, I'm going to get a bus. Uh-oh. It looks like my watch is working properly, right? Bogey crap. Look, can you stop filming now, please, everyone? Can you stop filming, please? Stop it. Go away and stop it. I've asked if you could stop filming, please. Go away. S-T-A-P. Now. Thank you very much. Right, I'm in a supermarket. As you can see, all over the place there's food. Why is that? Well, because if it wasn't here, then for most of these people, coming to the supermarket would be a completely wasted journey. Beans, sausages, cornflakes, foods from all over the world gather at Tesco's. It's a Eurovision Song Contest of food. But, you know, without all of the unpleasantness. So, all aboard your trolleys, viewers, and let's go on a gastronomic trip around the world.
Achtung, Spitfire, Donner and Blitzen, 999, argh! German sausage.
Hacha, Jock, I'm completely drunk. Are you? So am I. Oh, look, there goes Billy Connolly. Porridge.
All right, cover, kangaroo. I'm even more drunk than that Scottish black was. That's why I go around wearing this hat with the flap nailed to my brain. It's Australian pears.
Ah, so.
It's Plank Gletchley.
All right, mates. Just been reading some of the words that they keep in this history book. I won't tell you which ones, because it'd take too much time. But it's mainly about the news from the olden days. And let me tell you, things weren't so casual in them days. It wasn't all bus tickets and news at 10 in 1791. Because on that very same day, right, the French invaded Redditch. And as the first of their soldiers appeared at dusk, only one man stood in their way. Must have been quite a big bloke, I think, but anyway, that's not really important. His name was Marquis. Marquis of Redditch. And as the blood began to flow, the people were to rename the town Red Ditches Full of Blood, which they later inebriated to Redditch. Let's see what I mean.
Thank you. French casualties, 285 million. English casualties, the Marquis of Redditch. Kevin Turvey, BBC Two, The Battle of Redditch.
Tully's crap today.
What do you mean that there's a war film on any beat? Bandits at 5 o'clock.
Horse bandits at 5 o'clock, more likely. Want to see these Hollywood poofs go through what I went through.
What did you go through?
What didn't I go through?
No, what did you go through?
I'm talking about what I didn't go through.
Well, what wasn't it then?
I'd rather not talk about it if you don't mind, Kevin.
All right.
But, when you faced a tank with nothing more to defend yourself than a chair, then you'll understand.
Understand what?
Understand what it is to look death straight in the eye.
Well, I've been run over as well. Not by a tank.
Well, neither have you, you vast bogey. Well, I would have done if I hadn't run away.
Run away? I'm surprised you could run at all. I expect the word that you was looking for was waddled.
Listen, mate, I am a human spring. This is all muscle, you know. Just doesn't happen to be tensed at the moment, that's all.
It's probably a good job. If you tense that much, you break your neck.
Listen, mate, when I was in the army, I could run upstairs. That's how fit I was. You see these?
No.
Do you see these?
Yes.
These aren't hands, these are killing machines.
Killing machines?
Yeah. If I had a gun in either of these, you'd be a dead man.
Shut up. Look, do you want to watch the film or not?
I don't care. Do you know what I miss most about the army?
What?
Sitting in my own mess.
Saturday night, it's 5:30, time of the week when a bloke likes to let his hairs down, you know, go out and have a bit of a good time. So I think I might take a bit of a girl out tonight, you know, show the lights. I don't exactly know which ones yet, but that depends on the girl, really, doesn't it? So that's what we need. Ah, girl. A bit of romance. A bit of je ne sais de vivre. That's right, Teresa Kelly.
It's ringing, I can hear it. Come on, half pants, the kid's in town. Right. Oh, hello, Mr. Kelly. Yeah. Yes, that's right, yes, it is Kevin Turvey. Yeah, but it's all right, because I just got the wrong number or something, I think. No, I don't want to speak to Teresa, no, it's... Yeah, probably is a good thing too. I think that as well, yeah. Well, I don't really think I could do that, Mr. Kelly. You know, not unless I had a special operation beforehand, something like... No, I'm not trying to be clever. I just... All right, yeah, well, I'll definitely try that one. Yeah? Yes, and I'll definitely do that one as well. Yeah. But I don't think I'll be able to do them both at the same time, though. You know, not without a wrench or something like... Oh, I can do that instead, can I? Right, well, I'll just have to wait until Mick gets out of the toilet before I do that. You know, get a bit of privacy or something. Right, well, thanks very much for your help, Mr. Kelly. Yeah, No, I won't ever. No, never again, no. I'll break the phone or something. All right, then. I couldn't just have a word with Tere... All right, bye-bye. You know what? I'm getting a bit tired with all this telephoning. I think I might give it a bit of a miss tonight, actually. Just pop straight up and go to bed or something. Yeah, I'll write her a letter or something in the morning, cancelling tonight. Yeah, that's best.
Good evening. picnic, everybody, wherever you are. My name is Kevin Turvey, and this is the 20th century. When you're alone and life's like Mac and you're lonely, you can always go downtown, right? When you've got worries, all the noise and the hurry seems to help. I know that. Downtown. Just listen to the rhythm of the traffic in the city. Linger on the sidewalk where the neon signs are pretty. How can you lose? The lights are much brighter there. You can forget all your worries, forget all your cares, and go downtown. Everything's great when you're downtown. Don't wait a minute more. Downtown. Everything's waiting for you. Something else that I could tell you about is there are movie shows downtown. Maybe you know some little place you can go to where they never close downtown. Just listen to the rhythm of the gentle bossa nova. You'll be dancing with them too before the night is over. Happy again. The lights are much brighter there. You can forget all your work. Please forget all your cares and go downtown. Everything's great when you're downtown. Don't wait a minute for downtown. Everything's waiting for you. Take it away. Someone to help and understand you. Someone who is just like you and needs a gentle hand to guide them about. So maybe I'll see you there. We can forget all our troubles, forget all our fears, and go downtown. Everything's fine when you're downtown. Don't wait a minute for downtown. Everything's waiting for you. Bitch!